गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द लीनियर ऑपरेटर्स एंड फंक्शनल्स ऑन फाइनाइट डायमेंशनल स्पेसेस। सो फर्स्टली लेट अस डिफाइन द अलजेब्रिक ड्यूअल ऑफ अ वेक्टर स्पेस एक्स। सो लेट अस टेक अ वेक्टर स्पेस एक्स, देन द सेट ऑफ ऑल द लीनियर फंक्शनल्स डिफाइंड ऑन दिस वेक्टर स्पेस that is also a vector space and it is denoted by the symbol x star and it is called algebraic dual of the vector space x and the algebraic operations of this vector space are defined in the usual way, vectors addition and scalar multiplication. So if we are to define the vector addition, that is defined by taking f1 and f2 to elements of x star and at x belonging to x, the sum of these functionals f1 and f2, that is defined by f1 plus f2 and that is given by the functional g whose value at every point of x is defined by g of x is equal to f1x plus f2x. And to define the scalar multiplication, let us take a scalar alpha and a functional f. Then their product alpha f, that is denoted by a functional p whose value at every point x of the vector space x is defined by p of x is equal to alpha into fx. So these are the operations which are defined on the space x star. Now we can also define the second dual of x, the algebraic dual of the first dual x star, that is denoted by x double star, and the elements of this dual are the linear functionals defined on the dual space x star. It means the dual of dual, that is denoted by x double star, and that is called second algebraic dual of the vector space x. So in general we can say that if we have the vector space x, its elements are vectors denoted by x, and for the algebraic dual of x star, the elements are functionals of this form whose value at the point x are given by f of x, and the second algebraic dual of x is denoted by x double star. Its elements are also the functionals, but these are the functionals defined on x star, and the value of g at f, that is denoted by g of f. Thus we can obtain an element g belonging to the second algebraic dual of x, which is a linear functional on the dual x star, by choosing a fixed element x from the vector space x. So we can define g of f is equal to gxf. Here x is written in the suffix to show that this is corresponding to the fixed element x belonging to the vector space x, and this is defined by f of x, and this belongs to the field of scalars k. Now we claim that this g is a linear functional. To show that g is linear, let us take two scalars alpha and beta from the field of scalars, and f1 f2 we have taken two functionals. Let us take the image of alpha f1 plus beta f2 under g. Now by using this definition, g of f, that is defined by f of x, so that will become f of x means alpha f1 plus beta f2 x. So because alpha f1 and beta f2, they belongs to x star, so by definition this can further be written as alpha f1 of x plus beta f2 of x. Now alpha and beta are scalar and f1 and f2 are linear functionals, so this can further be written as alpha f1x plus beta f2x. So this proves that g is a linear functional. Thus, for every vector x belonging to the vector space x, there exists a functional from the second algebraic dual of the vector space x. And correspondingly, we have a mapping c from x into x double star, which is defined by taking the element x from here. C of x is equal to gx. Here, gx is defined by gx of f is equal to f of x. For every f belonging to the first dual of x, this mapping C, that is called canonical mapping of x into x double star. And also, this mapping is a linear operator. Now, next we define linear operators and functionals on finite dimensional spaces. So let us take x and y are two finite dimensional vector spaces over the same field. And let us take t from x into y is a linear operator. Now, because these two spaces are finite dimensional, so let us choose a basis for x as well as y. So the basis for x is consisting of the vectors e1, e2, e3 up to en. And the basis for y we have taken as a set consisting of vectors b1, b2, b3 up to br. These are arranged in a definite order which we keep fixed. Now, because this is the basis for the vector space x, so every element of x can be written as the linear combination. So for x belonging to x, we have a unique representation of the form x is equal to exile 1 e1 plus exile 2 e2 and so on up to exile n en. Here exile 1, exile 2, up to exile n, these are the scalars. Now because t is linear, therefore we can say that x will have the image given by y is equal to t of x. Substituting the value of x here and using the linearity of t. So y can be written as a linear combination of the vectors t of e1, t of e2 up to t of en. So in the summation form, we can write y as summation exile k t of ek, where k varies from 1 to n. Now because the representation of x is unique, so we can say that t is uniquely determined if the images t of ek of the basis vectors are prescribed. And also, because y and yk, these are the vectors in the vector space y, and the basis of y we have taken as a set B consisting of vectors b1, b2, b3 up to br. Therefore, y can be written as a linear combination of the vectors of the basis. So we have taken the scalars eta1, eta2 and so on up to eta r, such that y can be written as the linear combination given by eta1 into b1 plus eta2 into b2 and so on eta r into br. Now the value of y is of this linear combination form, means y is summation eta j into bj. Here j varies from 1 to r. And also the vector t of ek, that will also has a representation of the form of linear combination of the vectors of the basis B. So we can take a representation given by summation tau jk bj. These are the scalars and j varies from 1 to r. Now we can substitute these two values in the equation second. So we get y, the value of y, which is summation eta j bj. And on the right side we have summation exile k into the value of image of ek under t. So substituting the values here, we get summation eta j bj is given by summation j varies from 1 to r and summation k varies from 1 to n tau jk into exile k into bj. Now because the set B forms the basis of the set y and the vectors of basis are linearly independent, so we can equate the coefficients of bj on both sides. Here on the left side the coefficients are eta j and on the right side these are summation tau j k exile k. And here j varies from 1 to r and k varies from 1 to n. Thus, we can say that the coefficients in the equation 4, they form a matrix which we have denoted by the matrix T, E, B and is having the coefficients tau, j, k. This is a matrix of order r cross n. Now, we turn to the linear functionals and using the results which we discussed. So, let us take x be a vector space having the dimension n and the set consisting of vectors e1, e2, e3 up to en, this be the basis of x, which is in a definite order but kept fixed. Now, we know that the linear functionals of x, they forms the space which we discussed is called algebraic dual space, x star. And every element of x star is a functional. Let us denote an element by f. So for every such functional and for every element x of the form of linear combination given by summation exile j ej, we can find the image of x under f that is given by f of x. Now substituting the value of x here, this will become f of summation exile j ej. Now this can further be written as summation f of exile j ej. Now because f is linear, so this can further be written as summation exile j into f of ej. Now f of ej we have denoted by alpha j for every j which is varying from 1 to n. So we can write f of x is equal to summation exile j alpha j where j varies from 1 to n. Thus we can say that this functional f is uniquely determined by its values at the n basis vectors of the vector space x. And also conversely, every n tuple of scalars alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha n, they determines a linear functional on x by using these two equations. Now if we take n tuples in particular, first is having the 1 on the first place and all other 0. In the second, we have taken 1 in the second place and all the other 0. And in the nth, we have taken 1 at the nth position and all the other entries 0. Then by using the equation 5, we have n functionals. We denote them by f1, f2, f3 up to fn. And the values of these functionals at ej, these are denoted by the Kronecker delta function del j k. By definition, when j and k are different, their values will be 0. And when j and k are same, the value is 1. Thus, we can say that these functionals fk has the value 1 at the kth basis vector and at the other remaining basis vectors, the value is 0. So, this set consisting of the functionals f1, f2, f3 up to fn, that is called dual basis of the given basis e1, e2, e3 up to en.